this great opportunity to say good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls watching us across Uganda. This is Urban Television. And guess what? The Guild presidential debates are back. Today we're delighted to be hosting Islamic University in Uganda female campus. That is in Kabuja, that is 1.5 kilometers away from Natete town. But well, we have two candidates, and of course they're all pursuing the presidential seat for the university. But I'm going to go through your profiles first, starting with our first candidate, that is Nasoga Swahiba. That is her real name. She does a course of public administration. She's in high year two. And her slogan is thinking in terms of possibilities. And our second presidential candidate in the house tonight is Natongo Bashir, real name. Doing a course of education, year two, slogan, I guarantee service delivery. Alright, so let me take this opportunity to also welcome our audience, our live audience in studio. Maybe I can give you just 1-2 seconds to just clap for your candidates in the house right now. Alright, it's about that time we hear from the candidates. And of course, they say hello to us and get to know them a little bit better. Starting with Miss Nasuga, how you doing?
I'm great.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah.
All right. So say hello to the people watching you.
Hello, Uganda. This is Nasuga Swahiba talking to you. Pursuing a bachelor's degree in public administration, year two. And that is Islamic University in Uganda, females campus.
All right. And of course, also, let me take this opportunity to say, Natongo Bashir, say hi to the people.
Hello, Uganda. My name is Natongo Bashir, a student of the Islamic University in Uganda, pursuing a bachelor's in arts education, and I'm in my year two. I major in history and Islam, and here, aspiring for the post of the Guild President. Please give me your mandate.
Well, just a reminder, this is the females campus. IU has a couple of campuses. We have the Kampala campus. We have the Mbali campus as well. Not leaving out the other one. We have also the Arua campus. Exactly. All right. Both of the candidates have slogans. And first things first, I want them to tell us more about the slogan, starting with you, Nasuga. Your slogan says, thinking in terms of possibilities. What exactly are you trying to define to us?
When I say thinking in terms of possibilities, there, I call upon my fellow ladies to chase away that negativity in their lives and always think that everything is possible in life. Whenever you have your God, and whenever you have faith in your God, then everything is possible in life.
All right. Looking at the slogan for our candidate two, that is Natongo Bashir, it says, I guarantee service delivery. Tell us more about your slogan.
My slogan is, I guarantee service delivery.
Yeah.
And by that, I mean that every leader we elect, every leader we vote into power has a right or is entitled to serving us, because that is the main reason as to why we put them in power. So I'm here and I mean the slogan, that is I guarantee service delivery, because I'm going to be questioned by Allah on the day of judgment about my leadership, inshallah.
All right, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Reminding everybody who's watching at home, especially students of IUIU, that you can go on our social media, that is Urban Television on Facebook. First things first, you like the pages, you follow the pages, and then you can be able to, you know, if you have a question for any of the candidates in the house, you can comment on the poster that you'll see there. For the meantime, we need to get to know why exactly they decided to contest for the presidential post. Ms. Nasuga, tell me, why did you decide to contest for this post?
First of all, I think this has always been a dream. And so if I really fulfill it, I'll be very grateful and happy.
Mm.
And whenever you are happy, whenever you do something out of love, then you do it perfectly.
Sure then.
So I hope and I believe I'm going to serve the best.
All right. Have you served any post before in the university or in your high school?
Yes, in my high school.
Okay.
And that is Bugembe Islamic University, Bugembe Islamic Institute in Jinja.
Okay.
I was a head girl. That was 2015, 2016. Then I was a sports prefect. That was 2013, 2014.
2014. Yeah. All right. Thank you. Let's also listen to Miss Nantong Bashir. Why did you decide to contest for the post?
First of all, naturally, I believe I'm a leader because whenever I stand, I feel I have the confidence and the capability to be a leader. And the other issue is, currently I'm a student at the Islamic University in Uganda, and obviously the reason as to why I'm contesting for this office of the Guild President is because I'm seeing some loopholes, some things that need to be tackled as a student leader, and I'm here to help my fellow students achieve their goals, inshallah.
All right. Let's look at the outgoing guild cabinet. Starting with you, Nantong Bashir. Are you happy with their service delivery in their term?
First of all, I would love to thank the outgoing guild cabinet because it takes courage, and I believe one time, that was last year, they were also, it was 2019-2020, yeah. They are also like us, they are also standing here, and it took a lot of courage, and I know what it means because I'm also here. I thank you, the outgoing kid cabinet, and I believe no one can be perfect. We can only try and do the best and better serve the Islamic University.
I would love to know some of those loopholes that, you know, you have, you know, identified, you know, doing some research about, and you found that a few things that you feel that were not done right by the cabinet that is outgoing.
Yeah. First of all,
we don't want to talk about the positivity only and, you know, cheer them up for the time, but also I'm looking at what failed.
That's true, because I'm a victim of circumstance.
Yeah.
When I joined the Islamic University in Uganda, that was 2018-2019, I was a victim. First of all, I believe that the role of the leaders is to mentor these young ones, all these freshers who just joined the university. But I've not yet seen that because these freshers come from the secondary schools and they are new in the society of university. So they need to be mentored, they need to be talked to and guided so that they don't make mistakes the moment they are in the new society.
Should we say we don't have, Females Campus doesn't have an orientation program?
It has, but then it has to be frequent because they only talk to them in that orientation week.
Yeah.
So it's supposed to be the role of the guild cabinet to frequently meet these people and make friendly relationships with them so that they can easily air out their issues.
Okay. All right, Nasuga, tell us, what do you think about the outgoing cabinet? Anything you're really positive about it and anything you feel wasn't done right?
It's only appreciating the outgoing cabinet because no one in life is perfect and we are all human beings. So what they achieved and what has not been achieved, I'm here to fulfill it.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, amazing. So, Nasuga, what you're saying is that there is nothing at all completely you feel disappointed or you feel wasn't done right.
Okay.
In the cabinet.
I feel there is still that gap between the students' connection with the administration.
Okay.
Although they felt tooth and nail, but since they are human beings, they didn't fulfill it to the level expected. But now I'm here to bridge that gap.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen watching us tonight, in case you just joined us on TV, well, this is Islamic University in Uganda, Females Campus, Kabuja. And we have two candidates. One is Nasuga Swahiba. slogan, thinking in terms of possibilities. And the second candidate is Nantongo Bashir, who says, "I guarantee service delivery." We're going to take a break right now, sip some water. When we return, we dive into their manifestos. You can also join the conversation online by going on our pages. That is Urban Television. See you in a bit. My name is Casmir.
That was very nice.
And of course, we are back. We're delighted to the fact that, you know, the Guild presidential debates are officially back on Urban Television. And for the first time this year, 2020, we are holding our first edition with IUIU Females Campus, Kaboja. That is 1.5 kilometers away from Natete Town. It's about that time I go on social media and read out a few questions from you, the audience that is watching across Uganda and abroad. And as well, hear the final remarks from the candidates. So the first question comes in from Madina, says, "I look forward to working hand in hand with the team implementing attainment. It's Females Campus, a place for higher education for girls." This is not a question, I think. Madina, I didn't clarify that. Okay, it's fine. Then we have somebody called Hasif Dada, says, "Thank you, Kasme. Greetings to the aspirants. My question goes to Bashir. Yes, you are guaranteeing service delivery, but again, there is a problem of conflicts, interest. How will you mend the confusion between the interests of the students and the interests of the administration?" This question goes out to both of you. This is Daud M. Fulgens. Daudi, okay. He's watching in from Tanzania, saying he likes the debate and the challenge to both candidates. Where do they see themselves in the near future, focusing much in leadership? And then this one it still goes out to you, Ms. Nansuga, saying, "How is she going to promote self-esteem among our sisters so that they can pick a leaf from her?" And then still for Bashir, this is from Sophie. Jeff says, "How will you bridge the gap between students and the administration?" For the meantime, as I look for more questions, please, I'll start with you, Nansuga. Please answer the questions that are being asked. The generic question and your personal question.
Of course. Where do I see myself in the nearby future? Of course, from now, I'm training to be a good administrator, a hardworking one. And of course, I really hope to be to one day be in the parliament as one of the...
Okay.
Then how I would promote self-esteem among the fellow ladies is by talking to them and sharing to them the benefits of studying and the benefits of working as a lady. Because we are the bottom, we are the starting point, we are the mentors, then others follow us.
Right. The questions, okay. Somebody from online says, it's called Sadi Muga says, this is Rama Sadi Najagwe, says she's watching the show. Thank you so much for tuning in. And then Anne says, Nantongo Bushra, the sky is the limit, Han. Okay, can you please answer the questions as well?
I would love to also thank you for the wonderful questions. They asked me a question of how am I going to protect the interests of the administration and the interests of the students. The Islamic University in Uganda, Fimose Campus, first of all, the students will know that by the time you're admitted at the university, they give you the rules and regulations that govern the university. And for that, I'm here to do the possible, because they will know what is illegal in the university and what can be done, inshallah. They asked me another question. Where am I seeing myself in the future? First of all, as I said, I'm pursuing a bachelor's in arts education. Obviously, I see myself as a successful teacher, an administrator, and later, inshallah, I believe I will join the politics of the Uganda, inshallah.
All right. First of all, that question, the generic question of where you see yourself in the near future, coming in from a gentleman who's watching in from Tanzania. So I want to say hello to those watching it from Kenya, Rwanda, and South Sudan as well. Okay, getting back on social media, this is Muganzi Sectrin. He's watching in from Nkozi, Masaka, from that university in Nkozi, Uganda Matters. Says, hey, MC Casmel, thanks for the show. My question goes out to both candidates. How are you going to manage your leadership and, you know, balancing your books? And then this one is called Shakira, says, this is for Nasuga Swahiba. How are you going to make our DAO functional? It has faced a setback these days and need to be improved. How are you going to make it? And well, another one is from Sheena. Says, I'm wishing good luck to both candidates. But I pose my question to Bashira that they have talked everything, but I haven't heard anyone talking about the non-residents. Don't you have plans for them? Okay, so we can answer that for the meantime, starting with you, Nasuga.
How to manage books and administration
and leadership.
And leadership. I believe in myself. I know I've ever been a leader before, and I know I believe I'm a bright student. It was one of the qualifications that led me up to this point. So I believe I have that confidence to keep it up.
All right.
Then how I would make DAO function more functional? I hope to do this by working hand in hand with our imam and the Dawa cabinet, so that we bring in more sheikhs to elaborate more about our religion and the benefits of understanding who your God is. Then their Dawa will be functioning.
All right, let's listen to you, Natongo.
The first question was, how will I manage leadership and books? Obviously, books come first, because these papers are so important, and these papers are the ones that will take us to the future leadership, inshallah. So it's obvious I will have to give time to my books as well as my leadership, because they are a key in the future. Okay, they are key and fundamentals towards my success, inshallah.
All right. A couple of questions are coming in, but because of time, we will not be able to. But I want to thank everybody who's posting and sending in your comments right now. And I'm very glad to be hosting, you know, the Females Campus 2020. All right. One more last question from me. It goes out to both of you. In case you don't win, right, English, yeah? What would be your plan B, starting with you, Nasuga?
If I don't win. In Islam, I do believe that everything is by Allah's will. So if I win, alhamdulillah. If I don't, I still thank him.
All right. Same to you. In case you don't win, what will be your plan B as a leader?
Thank you for that question. In case I don't win, I would like to inform everyone watching this that leadership is God-given. And if I'm not given this right, again, alhamdulillah, and I will have to admit and work with the new, with the incoming guild body to implement and to contribute towards the progress of the Islamic University in Uganda.
Okay. Your final remarks. This is the moment I'm giving you to officially speak to our live audience, to speak to those that are watching on their TV sets at home, in halls of residence, at hostel, wherever they are in Uganda or abroad. Why they should vote for you as the next guild president for the famous campus.
First of all, I would love to thank everyone who is watching this show. Thank you for that time. Thank you for that spirit. And I would love to tell you that, inshallah, I'm the right person because I believe and I know that I know the areas to tackle. I know the areas where I should put more emphasis and the areas that are going to contribute towards the progress of the Islamic University in Uganda.
All right. Nasubga, what are your final remarks as well? Talk to the people.
Thank you everyone watching out there. The students of Islamic University in Uganda who are online, thank you so much. And I know success is not a one-man's game, so I really urge for your support and vote tomorrow. Tomorrow is the voting. Then I believe that if you are ready for change, I'm ready to serve.
All right, now you have heard it all for the last 1 hour. Well, they've given you their manifestos and they've answered literally most of your questions. So we leave the ball in your hands, students of IUIU Females Campus, and we're looking forward to the best candidate, and may the best candidate win. From the team of Urban Television, we thank you so much for tuning in. Keep it locked. So much is coming up. Movies are coming up. And you can catch me from Monday to Friday, 5 p.m., 5 to 7. And as well, you can catch me on Campus 101 every Saturday, 11 a.m. May God bless you and bless us too. Assalamu alaikum. Ladies and gentlemen, you can clap, please. No problem. Yeah. Well, for the rest of you who are at home, it's going hard in here because, you know, we have a live audience. And we have two lucky candidates, you know, and one of them is going to be the next guild president for IUIU Female Campus. It's about that time I give a chance to, you know, the ladies in our live audience, you know, to ask questions. And I would love the questions you ask, at least you ask the opposite candidate. Don't ask your candidate because I know you ask simple questions, yeah? Don't make it so hard or simple for them, yeah? So please, ask your questions. Start with your name.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Nachwa Jamida. My question goes to Honorable Bashira. Regimes are different. In case you're elected to be the guild president 2021, how are you going to make your cabinet different from the past cabinets?
All right. Let's finish all the questions at once. They'll keep start answering them at once as well to save time, yeah? All right. Pick the next the next person, pick the microphone.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. My question goes to Honorable Shahiba. You said you're going to act as a voice, eh? How are you going to do that? And my next question is, you said you're going to work with the administration so that they can, okay, find jobs for the students, especially the finalists outside in the other organizations, eh? First and foremost, in most cases, they do cater for students who have first classes, Eh? So how are you going to help the other student who doesn't have a first class, but she wants a job? Thank you very much.
All right. Stand up and ask your question.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm Namkasa Zahara. My question goes to Honorable Nantongo Bashira. The question is, how are you going to bridge that gap or the loopholes that you've been saying or you talked about between the administration and the students? And another issue, how are you going to promote or to empower the girl child? Because you say that you're here to promote or to empower the girl child. Thank you.
Get the microphone, the next person asks. Start with a brief introduction.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And Brenda Simwe. My question goes to Honorable Nancy Oga. Please describe to us your decision-making process. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. My question is directed to Ms. Nantongo Bashira. There is a particular area I'm interested in, and that is the area of culture diversity. It is very crucial in our campus because we have students of multiple nationalities. What do you as a person have in stock for all of us that are from different countries?
All right, pass the microphone behind.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Angare Best Millennium is my name. My question is directed to Honorable Nancy Buga and as asking, how would you react to someone who is disagreeing with you? Yeah, that is it. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My question goes to Swahiba. You have said that our university teams, you're going to strengthen our university teams. I would like to ask, are you among any of these teams? And if yes, I would like to know which team and how are you going to do it?
All right. Final questions, okay.
Assalamu alaikum. A good evening to you guys. So I want to ask Nancy Buga a question. When you're leaving high school, you're always dreaming of MOOC, those campuses, those big campuses. How are you going to make a desirable campus for us for the freshers to choose in case they are leaving high school?
All right, two more last questions.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Hobra Musa. My question goes to Honorable Nantongo Bashira. You talked about night movies, night what? Like, how are you going to do it? Like, to us girls behind? How are you going to do it and empower us? Like, you talked about empowering girl child. How are you going to do it? And the other question is, you talked about our clubs. You talked about different clubs at the university. How are you going to bring them to the top? That's my question.
All right, final question. You haven't asked yet?
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. I'm Hanifa Kimshimran, and my question goes to Madam Nantongo. Please tell us any 5-hour activities that take place in the university.
All right, thank you very much. And that's, thank you so much, live audience, for the beautiful question. To serve time, so each of the candidates, you answer the question as brief as you can to serve time. So starting with Nasuga, kindly go through the questions one by one and answer them briefly, at least for 5 to 10 seconds. Okay.
The first question was about how I would act as a voice between the students and the administration. That is obvious. You approach me with your issue that is itching your heart. You tell me, I take it. If I can't solve it, I take it to the administration. Then second was about
okay.
I have the answer for it, but the question.
Decision. That's you about decision making.
Decision making. Yes, I would first sit with my cabinet before making any decision. I hear views from different ministers of mine. Then, if we don't get a conclusion, we seek advice from the administrators or our. We have the counseling and guidance team there. I would seek advice and then we solve the problem.
All right.
Then how I would react to someone disagreeing with me, just by giving her an advice and a word that I believe that person needs the best and I'm the best she needs. Then about the team or which team that I fall under, I'm among the swimmers, the swimming team. I do swim. Then how to make IUIU the first choice for the senior six leavers? Of course, by advertising IUIU and talking about good things about it, which are real. They are real. If we talk about good things, it's only good things in IUIU Females Campus.
Well, any other question?
It makes females feel comfortable.
Okay. Well, meanwhile, from my side, there is one thing I've realized about IUIU Female Campus is that it's one campus where we don't hear any type of, engagement. So, arrangement purposes. So, it needs to be worked on. Any other question you had before?
No.
All answered? Okay.
About?
The jobs.
The connection. Of course, this will call upon serious competition in academics. You have to compete to get the best.
All right, getting on social media. Shakira Mboa says, hey, thanks for the show. Mboa Shakira, Nasuga Swahiba, I wish you the best here. And then Hamim Musa says, hi, thanks for the show. I'm Hamim Musa, tuned in. Nantongo Bushra, I do wish you success. Okay, Ms. Nantongo, we also love to take this opportunity for you to answer the questions and, they need to hear your views.
First of all, I would love to thank you for the questions answered. It shows that you're concerned about your university, about its progress and prosperity. The first question was, how to make my cabinet be different from the other cabinets? First of all, as I mentioned, about the constant talks with the new students, that means that I'm going to be engaging my ministers, my cabinet members, to follow me and join me in this to get the best out of it. And the other issue is, obviously, when it comes to leadership, for one to prove that he or she is a leader, he has to do the necessary. A leader isn't supposed to be elected into office and sit back. You have to be active, and that is an assurance. I will not pick a dull student to be on my cabinet. Inshallah. The other question was, how am I going to bridge that gap between the students' fraternity and the school and the campus administration? First of all, I would love to tell you that everything is possible with communication. And I'm here as a friend, as a fellow girl, and as someone to take your voice to the administration, that is the Islamic University in Uganda. If you cannot air out your views, if you cannot air out your problems, I am here to help you air out these problems If you can't approach the administration, I'm here. I'll help you take the issues to the concerned people so that they can be tackled. And the other question was, how am I going to empower the girl child? First of all, I thank the Islamic University in Uganda because it's doing so. And we are all girls, and they are empowering us. That's why we are here. That's why we have this confidence, and that's why we are here on a national TV. How am I going to empower this girl child? First of all, the Islamic University in Uganda, Females Campus, Kawoja, is in a society where there are various secondary schools. We need to, I assure you that, inshallah, I will have to work hand in hand with my cabinet, move to these various schools, and so that these girl children can be motivated and they can be made to be various successful personnel in the future, inshallah.
All right. Thank you very much. I believe all your questions have been answered. But well, I have one question, or two questions, in other words. If you believe Nasuga Swahiba deserves to be your next guild president, let me hear that noise. And if you believe Nanto Bashir should be your next guild president, let me hear that. Alright, how about we take a break right now, and when we come back on the presidential guild debate, IU Female Campus Edition, of course I'll be taking a few questions from our social media, and as well give them their final remarks when it comes to this debate. Thank you very much. Keep it locked. See you in a bit. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we are back, and of course tonight we are all hosting IU Females Campus Presidential Guild Debate, one of a kind, first of a kind, 2020, where we have two candidates battling it out for the presidential post in the university. We also have our live audience where we have fans of both candidates. Maybe I'll ask them one question. Who do you think is going to win? But well, that will also depend on their manifestos, and of course me as Casmiel, I really want to listen to, you know, what they have in stock for us, you know, when it comes to this year, 2021. And I'll start with Ms. Nantong Bashir. Tell us about your manifesto. What do you have in stock for the students that are watching you across Uganda from IUIU and the ones that we have in the house?
First of all, I introduce myself. I'm Nantong Bashir once again. And why I want you to vote Nantong Bashir is, first of all, I plan to be more innovative and creative so that I promote the Islamic University in Uganda. How am I going to do this? First of all, we have clubs in the university, and we want us to join hands, especially those who are new in the university. Let's join hands. Let's boost these clubs in the university. Let's get what to do and make ourselves busy. And the other thing is, as I earlier said, that keeps on haunting me. I want these fellow girls who are new in the system to be mentored. Let them be befriended. They need someone to talk to them frequently so that they get used to the environment. And then the other issue is, I would love to work hand in hand with the administration of the Islamic University in Uganda. That is to air out students' views and to do those activities that are going to boost the Islamic University in Uganda, not only in the society, but also in other parts of the country. And the other thing is, I would love to engage my fellow students, those are the girl children, to in various activities. For example, I'm happy to inform you that we have a new faculty, that is the Faculty of Health Sciences, which teaches nurses and midwives. I would love to tell you that these people, if at all they manage to get those skills they need to use, I'll say, before they get a clue about how to handle various things, I would love them to do that in various communities as Muslim ladies, inshallah. And the other thing is, the Islamic University in Uganda has a marketing department, but this marketing department has a few members. I would love to cope up with the students of the Islamic University in Uganda, those are the fellow girls, to join this marketing department and make it their responsibility to market the Islamic University in Uganda female's campus. And the other important thing to note is that the Islamic University in Uganda female's campus was mainly formed to promote girl child education. So we need to go to those schools, inshallah. We talk to these girls, let them have that morale and that confidence that they need to go and study. And that's why I'm aspiring for the office of the group president 2020-2021, and I please request for your mandate, inshallah.
All right, thank you very much. Yeah, you talked about clubs, talked about marketing, some of one of the things that I think I'm going to try later on. And well, also I'd love to find out, have you held any post before in the university or before that?
In the university, I've not yet held any post.
Mm.
But previously, that was 2013, 2014, I was the assistant mess prefect at Kakungulu Memorial School. And in 2015, 2016, I was the head girl of Kakungulu Memorial School. I was the head girl of the Kakungulu Memorial Muslim Student Association.
All right, thank you very much. I'll encourage all the other campuses, the Kampala campus, the Arua campus, and as well the Bali campus, that you can go on social media, first of all, like our pages, Urban Television, and then you can be able to send some questions. I'll pick out a few of them as time goes by to listen, perhaps for the candidates to answer them. But for the meantime, also listen to Nansuga. What do you have in stock for the students? How can you impress them right now to go and, you know, vote that name as our new GIL president 2020-2021?
Yes.
Yeah.
Once again, I'm Nansuga Swahiba, a student of Islamic University in Uganda, female campus, pursuing a bachelor's degree in public administration. The reason as to why Swahiba Nansubuga should be elected to power as the GIL president, first of all, if elected to power, I would urge to the IUIU administration to at least link our finalists, the finalist students, to the outside organizations to avoid that tendency of unemployment to the educated lady out there
Okay.
The second reason as to why Swahiba Nansubuga should be elected to power is I hope to bridge that gap between the administration and us, the students. I'm going to do this by acting as a voice in between the students and the administration as I take their complaints to the administration so that they can be solved. Then the other issue is about resuming the students' court. This court it is there in actual sense, but it's not active. So I would like to resume it so that
it's called the what?
A student's court.
Okay.
Yes. So that if there is any chaos or some problems or conflicts between the students or among the students, we have to first listen to them before taking the complaints to the administration.
Right.
Then the other issue is about marketing IUIU as an Islamic university. this is going to be done with the help of our marketing department. I'm going to work hand in hand with it to help us, to help me and my cabinet, so that we market the IUIU Females Campus. And this only that I'm here standing in front and standing on Urban TV, it's only marketing. It's also marketing IUIU Females Campus.
All right, thank you very much. Anything else?
No.
All right. Your colleague talked about clubs, and I would love to know which clubs you are affiliated with. Starting with you, Nasuga, which club are you affiliated with to in the university?
The debate club.
The debating club. Yeah. Is it the most active club in the university?
Yeah.
All right, let me also find out from Nantong. Which club are you affiliated to in the university?
That is the debate club, because every Friday the law students hold what we call moot courts, and they tend to discuss and argue about various issues that concern the university.
Yeah. Apart from the debate club, which other clubs do you have in the university that are enrolled in?
We have the Baganda and Kubazambogo.
All right.
We have the science club.
Right.
We have the education. No? Yeah. We have the science club.
You only have two clubs?
No. No. Okay. The other clubs are like societies representing the various faculties. For example, the IUSA. We have the Law Society. We have the Faculty of Science. Those societies, you have also
the Interact Club?
No.
All right, because you know why I talked about the Interact Club. I know this is a university. Of course, it has its rules and regulations and its principles, given the fact it's a Muslim institute. Entertainment is key when it comes to university students. And if you have voted in as the next guild president, what kind of arrangement do you think you can put up to make students of IUIU Females Campus have a good time and not even think of, you know, moving out to look for fun outside the university?
Hmm?
Yes.
Okay. First of all, I'd love to inform you that we have various forms of entertainment at the Islamic University in Uganda Females Campus, Kawoja. For example, we have the swimming pool. It's also a form of entertainment. We organized cultural galas, and it was held last year. Then the other form of entertainment that I would love to introduce in is that we need to organize movie night. Since we are only females, it's okay to have a movie night.
Let me also give a chance to your other colleague to tell us, Nasuga, any arrangement you have for the students to make them feel at home, to have a good time, because they say work with no play makes Kasmela, you know, a dull boy. So what do you have for them?
First of all,
yeah,
I would urge our Islamic tutors, the tutors as in the people who train us, to put more effort and train training a serious school team that can act as an entertainment. It can act as an entertainment because we put can I call them? No. Like competitions, we put competitions.
Mm.
I hope to invite various universities, that's Makerere, Mok, I mean MOBS, and Chambogo University, for friendly matches, for friendly swimming days, so that we can get that entertainment.
All right, you have heard it all from them. And of course, I encourage everybody who's at home watching comfortably, or in a hostel or house of residence, to go on social media and join the conversation by simply going to our handles, that is Urban Television on Facebook. Like the page, and then you can comment and tell us how are they performing here? How are they performing here at the debate? Because, you know, this is a moment where you have to decide and see who's capable of being your next leader. And as well, Twitter and Instagram, it is Urban TV Uganda. You can as well follow me at MC Casmill, that is Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. For the meantime, how about I go in for a break? When we come back, we're going to give a chance to the live audience, you know. Keep it up.